Well, it started with three straight losses for the Edmonton Oilers, but in the opening minutes of Friday night's Game 6.
Here, glad who stopped Forsling. Forsling passed to Reinhardt too far. Skinner out to play that. Sam Reinhardt played for Kristoff Block with a goofy ice in his first year of junior. In fact, as a 15-year-old played along with his brother. Here's Dreisaitl working in. Leon Dreisaitl in front.
Oh, such a great sound. Oilers forward Warren Fogle scoring first for the Oilers, putting them up 1-0 over the Florida Panthers early in that game. They would go on to seal the deal with a 5-1 win over the Panthers. And the Oilers could take it all tonight in Game 7. Whether you're an Oilers fan or not, tonight's game will be historic if they win. So, who are you rooting for? The Edmonton Oilers, longtime rival of the Winnipeg Jets, or the Panthers, led by former Jets head coach Paul Maurice? Trevor Alexander joins me in the studio, writer for the hockey blog in Canada. And you can join our conversation. Tell us who you're rooting for and why. Call us at 204-780-0893. That's 204-780-0893. Trevor, welcome.
Thank you.
Can you walk us through these first six games? How did the Oilers get here?
Well, I mean, the first three games were, completely one-sided in that Florida kind of dominated from, start to finish and didn't really give the Oilers a lot of breathing room. The next three games looked like a completely different series in that, Edmonton found a little bit of room, used some quick transitions to get out of their own zone, pushed the puck up the ice, and all of a sudden everybody was back on their heels for the Florida Panthers. So, tonight, not to steal, any of Riley's thunder, but tonight the heat is on for both these teams. So, we'll have to see.
I like it. They felt like decisive wins, those last two games.
Yeah, no doubt there was, some very distinguishable scores in there where, that 8-1 pounding that Edmonton handed Florida was sort of the beginning of the little sort of comeback there. And you kind of look at what they've done, and they've played extremely well defensively. They've kept players to the outside, haven't let players get to Stuart Skinner in terms of keeping guys out of the middle. And then obviously transitioned the puck up the ice quickly, got it back down the ice, and really put some good pressure on Florida and pucks on the net for finding, goals and at least not goals, rebounds and chances to pick up the puck again.
I mentioned this could be a historic win. And if the Oilers win, what is that history that will be made?
It actually goes both ways for the Oilers. So it's for people that don't know this, 1942 was the last time a team rallied to win the Stanley Cup being down 3-0.
Wow.
Toronto Maple Leafs did that, and so Canadian team has a little bit of history there. The last team to rally to force a Game 7 in a Stanley Cup and lose was in 1945 when the Detroit Red Wings did it. So one way or the other, Edmonton's going to write some history tonight, one way or the other, just because of the significance of that Game 7 setup. But whether win or lose, they're going to be the new sort of footnote in history.
And it's been a while for the Oilers, just in general. They last won the Cup in 1990.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah.
Okay, and they made the Stanley Cup Finals in 2006, but lost to the Carolina Hurricanes.
Correct.
It's been a while, but the fan base seems like it just doesn't budge.
Let's not take anything away from the City of Champions. They kind of prided themselves on having that sort of winning mentality for so long. It went away a little bit in the 90s when they sort of had to retool, rebuild, and then came back, like you said, in 2006. But legitimately, this is a franchise that hasn't had a lot of, significant losses in the Stanley Cup final. They lost to the Islanders way back in, 70, whatever it was, 78 or whatever, before they decided to start, winning Stanley Cups. But at the end of the day, you got the best player in the world playing for a team in Edmonton again, in terms of having Connor McDavid there, having Wayne Gretzky there. It seems like this might have been, I don't want to say written in the stars, but at the end of the day, it's almost impossible. If he wants to take over a game, he can. And that's literally what happened in games 4 and 5.
Can we put this success just only on McDavid?
I don't know if that's entirely fair to say it's only him. Obviously Stuart Skinner's playing better. Obviously their defense is playing better. Leon Draisaitl's looked otherworldly as well. He's been showing everybody why he's the best player that's ever come out of Germany and in the way he's playing. They're getting lots of contributions, especially shorthanded, from guys that you may not expect. I don't want to say death by committee, but it's led by McDavid for sure. Mm-hmm. But everybody else is pulling their weight as well, which is kind of nice to see.
Right. If you're listening and you want to join in on this conversation, if you have thoughts on who you're cheering for, maybe thoughts on which players are making a big difference, someone other than McDavid, or maybe you're just a big McDavid fan, give us a call, 204-780-0893. That's 204-780-0893. Now, speaking of fans, there's a lot of excitement in Edmonton. Here's what some of their fans had to say. They were watching the game Friday at Edmonton's fan zone called the Ice District.
Oh, way to go, Oilers! I'm so proud of you! You can do it!
I graduated today!
So what was better, the graduation or the win?
I think the win. I got 2 degrees. This beats it, I'm not gonna lie.
This has been 18 years in the making. We have a jersey from 2006 when they were last in the Stanley Cup Finals. Look at this! We are there. We are taking this cup. We are taking this cup.
I drove here from Black Falls and I seen our jets still running, ready to head back to Florida. Let's go! Let's go!
Okay, let's talk about the fans and the fan support. This previous game, game six, how much do you think that the fan support really galvanized the team in that win?
I mean, you look at the way that they set up, you know, the arena. Everybody in that arena's got literally looks like they're wearing a jersey. Like, it is completely orange and or blue in that arena, no matter where you look. And they've done a great job. I mean, it's hard to compete. We heard it on that first clip where Draisaitl scored as well.
Yeah.
It's hard to deny hearing 16,000-17,000 fans all, you know, let's go Oilers all at once. It's a big part of it. And we talk a little bit about, you know, in sports anyway, about how fans can sort of, you know, sway the momentum one way or the other. In this case, them going home for game six, that was a huge, huge benefit for the Oilers for sure.
So now they're not at home. What change do you think that will make?
I mean, it'll be different to see what Florida gets out there tonight, because, I mean, we do know there are a lot of Canadians that are down in Florida most times. So it'll be interesting to see how many Florida fans come out. I mean, take nothing away from people that want to go to this game. The ticket prices for this game are insane on the secondary market. Like, we're talking, like, tens of thousands of dollars for tickets.
Tens of thousands?
Oh, yeah. Like, this is going to be, like, the hottest ticket to get in Florida at any point this year, sort of thing. But at the end of the day, though, I mean, Florida's fans could be a factor in this game, if not, you know, a little bit of a momentum sway. I guess the big thing to look at is, I mean, again, Florida 8-5 at home, or 8-4 at home this postseason. Edmonton 7-5 on the road. But they did win a game 7 in Vancouver to advance as well. So maybe it's a 50-50 when you look at it, but maybe the fans, again, can push them over the edge a little bit, give them a bit of an advantage on that, and have the Panthers show up a little bit better than they have in the last three games anyway.
Let's talk about Paul Maurice.
Yeah.
He's taken the Panthers franchise to the Stanley Cup Finals 2 years in a row.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on him?
I mean, no qualms about it. Paul is a fantastic quote anytime he's in front of a mic. He's a great coach, has a good mind for the game, did great things here in Winnipeg. Let's take nothing away from that as well. I mean, he turned this franchise from sort of, you know, the former Atlanta Thrashers into the Winnipeg Jets, and you kind of go, all right, like, he knows what he's doing. He's got a great group of guys there that legitimately believe in what they're doing. Is it enough to get them over the line? We'll have to see. I mean, obviously one game and any bounce can sort of change how the game goes. But at the end of the day, though, I mean, Florida has benefited from hiring Paul Maurice in a big way.
Do you think any Winnipeg Jets fans are maybe cheering for Florida because they still have a bit of a bit of a attachment to Paul Maurice?
I won't lie in saying that the 1980s have destroyed any sort of chance of Winnipeggers cheering for Edmonton. I mean, the Gretzky era was an absolute, like, killer for Jets fans if you were around at that point. Beyond that, though, sort of the new generation, I think it's divided. Obviously, you know, a lot of kids like McDavid, a lot of kids want to be like McDavid, whereas Paul Maurice is kind of the coach that was. I think you're going to get a pretty even sort of line in Winnipeg, depending on your age gap, and that's really where I look at it. I for one would want to see Paul Maurice win. He's been around long enough. He's done enough that he could win. I mean, Dmitry Kulikov is there as well. He was a former Jet, but I mean, that's besides the point. But on the other side, I mean, Mark Stewart's coach is an assistant coach for the Oilers as well, and Mark Stewart did a bunch of stuff for the city as well when he was a player here. So you're kind of divided if you're looking at just that. At, you know, who do you want to win? But I mean, let's not, you know, make any qualms about it. I mean, Paul Maurice legitimately could be a Winnipegger if he wanted to be. So, I mean, he was loved here for the time he was here.
He definitely was. What do you think the fact that it's been 30 years, I believe it's 30 years since a Canadian team?
Yeah, 1993. Yeah,
yeah, took the cup. Do you think that's going to sway any Jets fans?
There have been, especially from the U.S. media, there has been a lot of it's Canada versus
right.
us.
I've seen a lot of that out there.
And I don't know. I honestly don't think that people Canadians are pretty much, you know, a group of people that are going to cheer for their own anytime
right.
that we can.
Canada,
whenever Team Canada plays, we always got, you know, everybody behind the country.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to draw those lines demographically, though, when we were talking about regions. It's not like Islanders fans go across the bridge and start cheering for the Rangers when they're doing well. Like, there's a serious divide there. Same thing. Tampa Bay is not cheering for Florida right now. Like, Lightning fans hate Panthers fans and vice versa. So I don't know if it really exists that way. It would be nice to see, obviously, a Canadian team win. And I think a lot of Winnipeggers are okay with that in terms of having a Canadian team win. Yeah, it stings a little bit that it has to be Edmonton. But as long as Canada can erase that 1993 mark, I think we're okay with that.
All right. Well, if you're listening and you have something to say about whether you're cheering for Edmonton or not, even as a Jets fan, we still want to hear from you. 204-780-0893. You can give us a call. I want to go back to the last time Edmonton was in a Game 7 situation. They lost, and there was some post-game riots on White Avenue. A loss probably wouldn't do that in an away game, hey? People aren't going to be as
it depends.
Passionate?
I think that the hype has caught Edmonton pretty hard in that nobody expects them to lose tonight. Like, nobody. I mean,
really? Okay.
I'm not saying that there aren't doubters out there, but I think that with the momentum, with the three games they've played, with the way they've looked in those three games, I think there's a lot of believers in Edmonton right now that this, like, it's ours. Like, it's ours to lose. It's not it's not a matter of them winning. It's ours to lose.
Right.
And that could trigger maybe somebody, but you would hope that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
I would like to say that doesn't happen, only because why? Like,
well, yeah,
I get it's your chance, but it's also why? Like, it shouldn't bring about those kinds of reactions, in my view anyway. But end of the day, though, we'll have to see what happens
we'll have to
tonight.
See. Okay, so, what are you going to be watching for in tonight's game?
Obviously, I want to see first goal is going to matter. Whoever scores the first goal will set the tone for the rest of the game in terms of what's going on. So, I mean, you know, if you're relying on the last three games, Edmonton's been out in front early, which has been good for them. If you're relying on the first three games, obviously Florida got out in front and they could play their game after that. Beyond that, I think you're going to have to see special teams step up. Edmonton's penalty kill has been incredible. They scored two shorthanded goals. They've denied all but one power play goal for Florida so far. Florida's got to find a way to break through that and find a way to prevent Edmonton from bringing it back on them. And then lastly, goaltending. I think goaltending is going to matter. Bobrovsky has not looked like his... I mean, he came into the series, everybody talking about Conn Smythe, everybody talking about how he's the MVP, how he's going to, you know, be the guy this year in terms of leading Florida back to the promised land. And the last three games, he has been anything but, and Stuart Skinner's looked the opposite. So whether Stuart Skinner steps up, whether Sergei Bobrovsky steps up, one of those goaltenders is going to have to make a big save tonight, and probably several big saves tonight in order to win a Stanley Cup.
A lot of eyes on this game tonight. Thank you, Trevor, for setting that all up for us.
You're
appreciate
welcome.
It. Trevor Alexander is a writer with the Hockey Blog in Canada. Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals between the Florida Panthers and the Edmonton Oilers happens tonight. Puck drops at 7 p.m. And in any cup run in Canada, there's one song to rally the fans. For the Oilers, it's La Bamba.